cuff exercises are really, really simple to do. Most of them you can do lying down. You can start by simply doing the alphabet. And obviously you would do at some point both arms. Anytime you're lying on the floor, do be sure that you don't have the sphyg curve in your back. Be sure that your stomach, that your abdominal muscles are engaged, and that your small of your back is flat on the floor. And even if your legs are down, you still want that same flat back, but it's easier for a lot of people if your legs are up, if they're bent at the knee. Hi, Bear. Hi, sweetie. So you're going to just simply go through the alphabet. You can do uppercase letters, you can do lowercase letters, whatever you choose to do. It's a simple exercise, it's easy to remember, it's the alphabet. And anything that you're doing with regard to this, you need to try to stay within the frame of your body. So you don't want big, wide movements, you want these small, controlled movements. And however you want to, again, however you want to sign it, and then repeat for the other side. Really simple, really great exercise. You can also, and you can get a pillow, you can use your arm, again, engage your core, and you can start out with an exercise like this. Keeping your arm next to your side. And then you would reverse this way. And you would do those on both sides. So those are the basic little exercises for a rotator cuff. I was going to wind this up, show you a real, really, really easy, quick stretch that you can do anywhere. It is super if you are someone who works at a desk, if you spend a lot of time at a computer. It seems like these days there are so many things that we all do that we are in this kind of horrible hunched over position. You're going to use a door frame, any kind of door frame. Doors in your home, doors in your office, puppies. You're going to put your forearms onto the door frame and you're simply going to press against the door frame and lean forward. And it is an amazing stretch. You can feel a stretch all through your shoulders, through your neck, down through your low back, through the backs of your legs, even into your hamstrings. And it's just really, really helpful to do throughout the day, in the evening before you get ready to go to bed at night. So I just thought I would pass that along as well. Let me know if you have any questions. There are a lot of videos on YouTube, I'm sure, where people have are infinitely better set up to do exercise videos than I am. Again, Conchetta had asked me about this. She was wanting some encouragement to work on her arms, and so I did this specifically with her in mind, with the hopes that someone else might find it useful as well. Hope everybody is having a great day, and I will see you soon. Bye.